stop. Yeah. Hi, it's Lynn Pierce from AgelessLifestyleAfter50.com, and I'd like to welcome you to our Facebook Live today. We're talking about how many masks do you wear? And for the first time, I'm going to be using a whiteboard. So I kind of put this all together this morning when I decided to do this. I hope you can see it okay. I'm using my iPad, so for the first time, I cannot see what I'm doing. I have a friend here that will let me know if my internet disconnects. But this is the first time I'm not using my phone to do this. It just wasn't seeming to work. So we're going to get started right away, and I think it's important to know where the masks that we wear come from. And they start really, really early in our childhood. So could be as early as being a toddler when you first, in your mind, figure out that if you behave in a certain way, which is putting on a mask, you'll protect yourself or get the result that you want. So for kids, we learn that it would either be being helpless, I can do it myself, even as little kids being possessive and bossy, or being submissive. If you have little kids or maybe even little grandchildren, you probably see those behaviors in them and you're thinking, where does this come from? Because that's not who they are all the time, because they're already learning to put on masks for the different situations that they're in. Now, the next stage is when you're a little bit older of a child, and at this point, you could have masks of being a bully, being a victim, being a martyr, being a show-off, being reclusive or a loner. Now, these are just things that are coming to the top of my head. They are by no means all of the masks that we wear, but I think they're some of the most obvious masks that you'll be able to recognize as showing up in people that you know at these different stages of life. Then, as a teenager, well, don't even get me started on all the masks that boys and girls put on when it comes to dating, because there's a lot of those. But the other thing, especially for girls, is hiding our intelligence and hiding our abilities. That's a huge mask that we put on when we're teens. When you get a little bit older and you're in your 20s and you start entering the work world, you could put on the mask of being a bitch, being eager to please, having a chip on your shoulder, something to prove, ambitious, or selfless, helpless, want to do everything alone. I know when I was in my 20s, I definitely put on the mask of being a bitch and having a chip on my shoulder and doing it all on my own, because I was in a male-dominated industry in real estate. And not only was it competitive, but in most situations, I was the only woman. So there were several masks that I wore that helped me be successful. And sometimes they end up getting so ingrained that then they're difficult to take off. Now, when you get into your 30s and 40s, actually, that whole group together, you have different masks that come with career levels and parenting. So your masks shift. It's also a time of possible marriages, divorces. So then you've got ex-spouses, you've got new spouses in the mix, you've got possible stepchildren in the mix. And every one of these new roles that you play can come with its own masks that you wear. And there's also the career aspect of it, where you could be putting on masks that will allow you to move ahead in your career, or you're wearing masks that work against you and allow you to be left behind in your career. Now, I guess when I wrote this up, well, I would say 30s and 40s and then 50s. But either way, it's fluid. When you get into, especially into your 50s and 60s, which I guess is what I wrote down here. Yep. I would put the 50s and 60s together, even though I just did this a while ago. Because things are really shifting at this point. Every area of your life is shifting when you're in your 50s and 60s. You're starting to question the way that you've lived up until now. And you want to be more authentic and be more real. At the same time, there's possibly more masks coming because now there may be elder care involved, and now you're becoming a parent to your parents, and that's a whole new mask that you wear. So there's also empty nest when your kids go away, that shift your masks, because now the masks that you had been wearing have no place. And so there's a lot of confusion. There's also careers that are ending, either with forced early retirement or looking at retirement. Is retirement going to be actual retirement, or is it going to be a time of establishing a new career or a hobby? Doing something different, a passion project for the second half of your life. So all of those things contribute their own masks that, if we aren't really careful, keep piling up and piling up, and pretty soon we're wearing a whole bunch of masks. So all of our masks, I'm going to go over this way now so you can see me, all of our masks are either for our protection or they're for our advancement. So it depends on what we're trying to achieve. Are we trying to prevent ourselves from being hurt, or are we trying to gain something that we want to have in our lives? So either way, you're always asking yourself the question, who do I have to be? And these are the main things that you're looking for. So then the question, especially like I was saying, when you get into your 50s and beyond, is, okay, now that I'm starting to realize that I'm feeling uncomfortable with aspects of who I've been in the past, because if you don't realize that they're masks, you think that's actually who you are, and it's starting to feel uncomfortable, it's starting to feel a little bit phony or unreal as you're getting to know yourself better, and it's more important to be authentic and to truly be who you are. So when you're looking at removing them, one thing is you have to learn to love yourself more. When you learn to accept and love who you truly are, then you get more comfortable with all the uniqueness and idiosyncrasies of who you are, whether that's crazy or funny or whatever part of you that you might have tamped down a little bit before that. You just let who you are totally come out by loving yourself. And that's hard for people to learn how to do. The other thing is, you have to have a willingness to be vulnerable, to be who you really are, because you've spent a whole lifetime so far wearing all these masks that you thought you had to put on for people to like and accept you, for you to get ahead or protect yourself. And now you're at a place where you're going, God, all these masks are just getting really heavy. And I don't want to wear them anymore. How do I get rid of them? So it's a self-esteem issue as well. And as you learn to love yourself and you learn to be more vulnerable, then your self-esteem is going to rise. And when you feel more comfortable with who you are, then the people around you are going to react to that. And they're going to be more comfortable with who you really are. And as those masks come off, they're going to enjoy meeting that new person. The other thing is having a mentor. When you have a mentor that helps you through this process, it makes a difference because the mentor can see, I don't know if you want to call it the big picture or the view from 30,000 feet. As a mentor, I listen for what's behind the words that you're saying to find out how you really feel. And having someone outside of you help you with that process can make all the difference in the world. So one of the things that I can offer you is masks, and the whole conversation that we've been having is something we go into on a much deeper level in week 2 of How to Create an Ageless Vision for Your Life, which is a 6-week master course that is available right now. Standing in front of this, agelesslifestyleafter50.com/dream1. Dream the number one is where you can go to get a free gift. How to turn your dreams into reality right now. And there are some super incredible sets of questions in there that'll really start stimulating your subconscious to work on turning your dreams into reality. And then, of course, that will take you to the information on this master course that I would really encourage you to take a look at. We're going to be starting in 2 weeks. So it's coming up. So go and grab that free gift at agelesslifestyleafter50.com/dream1. And I'll put that in the comments as well so you can just click on it. And take a look at the master course. If anything that we've talked about or what you see there resonates with you, then I would encourage you to join us. I hope you've enjoyed this session. This is Lynn Pierce with AgelessLifestyleAfter50.com saying goodbye for now. Bye.